Did you know that if California was a country, it would be the fourth largest economy in the world? Well, I'm here at LAX Airport and just about to go home after hosting the Ireland Business Forum in association with South County EDC, Tracy Riviera, the West Coast Sevens, IIBN, Department of Foreign Affairs, and lots more besides. And I just wanted to record a little bit about what we spoke about on the day. You see, the thing is that I met a woman called Tracy Riviera in Bangkok at the Asian County Games. And this was where 1,000 players from all over Asia had come together to play GAA, and also a business forum took place at the same time. So Tracy and I had a chat anyway. Tracy runs the West Coast Sevens, which is the GAA tournament over here in San Diego. And she said, I'd love to put on a business event around our own sporting occasion. And I said, why don't you? And by the end of the conversation, I had agreed to work with her and to make it happen. So we did. And here's what happened. So first of all, I gave a keynote presentation about what's really going on in the Irish economy. So I spoke about the key challenge that we're facing regarding housing. And I spoke about the bright spots as regards that as well. For example, that completed dwellings are now up 25% this year, and the fact that wages are now up, the average earnings, hourly earnings in Ireland at the moment is €23.46, that the labour participation rate is up to 62.2%, and also, of course, that mortgage drawdown in terms of volume and value are up almost 20% each when in comparison to last year. So I spoke about that, but I spoke about the absolute acute challenges that we face in housing people at a social level, at making housing affordable to people who are starting off, and of course at making the market fluid for those people who want to right size, and particularly in the context of what's going on with Brexit, as we anticipate an influx of new foreign direct investment as a result. So I spoke about that, and I also spoke about the fact that while technology is amazing in lots of ways in Ireland, we have got fantastic investment in technology development, and also a lot of our universities are progressing in great strides as regards research and development as well. I did also speak about the fact that we are a digital services importer. In other words, that we in Ireland are going to spend 12 billion euros this year online, but 70% of that is going to go outside of the country. And you would have heard me talk about that before when I recorded the Future of Retail video a little while ago. So I spoke about that, but then I also spoke about the fact overnight, the news had come through about Theresa May, so I also spoke about what Ireland is doing as regards Brexit, and particularly what the agencies are all doing. And again, you would have heard me speak about that a while ago in the context of the Brexit All Ireland Summit. So I spoke about a wide variety of things there, and also mentioned, you know, a lot of people talk about the tax rate and that's why you should come to Ireland. And, you know, really and truly, I don't think that we're really being sold on that to a large degree. What we are being sold on is our talent, is our access, the only English-speaking country in the European Union after the UK Brexits, and also, of course, the talent of our people. And I mentioned the fact that 1 in 15 adults today is in third level education. 1 in 15 adults. So that includes, of course, people who are graduating from secondary school, as well as people who are returning to third level education after maybe they've taken time out for a variety of reasons. Now, that was the keynote. But in addition, we held a panel discussion, and I just want to give you a couple of statistics around, or maybe not statistics, I'll give you those too, but a couple of insights from the panel. So first of all, here's who we had. So we had Paul Robin, who is from, he's the Assistant Vice Chancellor of Innovation and Commercialization at the University of California, San Diego. Now that university is the largest campus in the world, spends $1.2 billion annually on research, and it's the city of San Diego has 10,000 people working in research. So he was coming from that perspective. We also had Paul Burfield. He was down from Enterprise Ireland, who was down from San Francisco, and he has responsibility for 14 states in developing opportunities for Irish businesses there. We had Dermot O'Shea from Tauglass, an exceptionally impressive business person, has built that business right around the world, met his business partner in Taiwan, and told me, as he told the audience, of course, that they could see pretty early on that if they were wanting to be serious in America, well then one of them needed to move over. So he is now over, he's got a base here in San Diego. Well, I was in San Diego at the time, and he shared his story. In addition then, we had Ken Behan from Sistran, and he spoke about what life is like here to build a lifestyle, to build a career, but also to build, or to be part of a business which is truly international and to have San Diego as the base. Separate to that then, all the way from San Francisco as well, we had Consul General Robert O'Driscoll, who came down from San Francisco. And in the fall, as he described, the Irish government is going to open a consulate in LA, also right here where I am right now. So that's going to be happening in the fall, which will be instrumental for the conversation that we had. Now, here's what came out of that discussion, right? For a start, they spoke about the fact that we don't, as Irish people and as Irish business people, tend to look to San Diego first, second, third, fourth. Really, it's not a key city that we're looking at from the point of view of developing Irish-California trade, despite the fact that San Diego is the eighth largest city in the US. And in addition as well, they spoke about the fact that there isn't a direct flight. Now, it's brilliant, the fact that you can land here in LA. I got here on Wednesday, had a dinner meeting within an hour with somebody from Loyola Marymount University here, and I could make it. Drove down, had a couple of other meetings as well along the way, but drove down and I could get down to LA. Now, taking into account traffic and that kind of thing, you're probably looking at about 3 hours really to get there, but that's all of a drive. And also, of course, there is a train service. Now, public transport in the US isn't amazing, but it's doable, and it's an awful lot more doable than having to get multiple flights along the way. So they spoke about what a direct flight into San Diego would mean, and not just from the point of view of convenience, because of course it's not about that, it's about increased trade links. Did you know also that San Diego is the most popular destination for J-1s? So for students who are coming out on the J-1 visa from summer, who are coming out for the summer into the US, San Diego is the number one destination that they choose. Around about 1,000 students a year come out here. And I spoke to people at the Irish Outreach Centre who are particularly the landing pad for them. So they spoke about that, they spoke about visas, they spoke about awareness. That really is the challenge. And I mean, we had 80 people who registered to come to our event on Friday morning. So the interest is there, and of course now it's up to us to consider what we're going to do thereafter about that. We used our BexSearch technology. As you know, BexSearch is our new business, focusing on breaking down silos and capturing tacit information within corporates and organizations. So we did that. We recorded the views of people within the room, and we'll be producing a report on that and submitting it to the Irish government later on in the week as well, when I get a chance to get my breath when I go home. So we did that, and we captured a wide variety of views. But I have to say, there really was a strong view that, you know, there's an awful lot of untapped potential here and not an awful lot standing in the way. Now, of course, right, it's a 10-hour flight home. Obviously, it was a 10-hour flight out here. You've got an 8-hour time difference, and you're dealing with a very expensive market, very, very expensive market. But at the same time, there's a lot of benefits to here, and the access points are all here. So it's going to be interesting to see how we can develop that along the way. I just want to mention as well is that, you know, what I loved about working with Tracy Rivieri and putting this together is that there's a fantastic network. And I mean, you hear me say that all the time. You hear me constantly talking about the global Irish and where they are in the world. But there's a fantastic network of people out here between LA and San Diego, Chula Vista, Carlsbad. I had a chance to talk to a number of people around the occasion, that was the Irish Business Forum, and also, of course, working with people in spreading the word about the event that we were going to be running as well. So it's really incumbent on anybody who wants to look at a region like this, in order to really tap into that and to see where it could go. But certainly the view was that it's not being harnessed to the same degree, and of course the consulate in LA is going to make a difference in that regard. But of course it's also up to you and me as well. Separately then, at the games at the weekend, so there was almost 600 people who came to the games from all over. I met people from I met a lot of Irish people who were living in Vancouver, Edmonton, LA, Denver, a lot of people from Orange County, Texas, Houston in Texas, Washington, San Diego, of course, themselves. So again, the GAA continues to act, I mean, as such a landing pad for these people and a great confluence for people to be able to connect as well. And then, of course, couldn't actually, you know, had to make sure that I got a chance to catch up with some family. So I met Ardal's cousin, Ardal, my husband, met the California branch of his family too. So on that note, been a hugely productive week. As you all know, the real work now is in the follow-up. Going to be making sure that I take care of that now over the next coming days. But just thought that you might like to know what's been going on stateside over the last couple of days here in San Diego. And now, as I say, I'm just about to head down here to the direct flight home to Dublin with Aer Lingus. Thank you and goodbye.